Hello all, my name is Manoj Matthew. Today I'll explain about a method known as DMATL, that is Decision Making Trial and Evaluation Laboratory Method. Unlike the traditional technique such as AHP, which assume that criteria are independent, this method identify the interdependence among the criteria. If you have watched my video on AHP, you'll come to know that we used to find the relative importance of one criteria over another for formulating the pairwise comparison matrix. But in DMATL, we assume that all criteria are mutually dependent and influence other criteria. So first step in DMATL is to find the direct relation matrix. The matrix is created with the help of comparison scale, where 0 represent no influence. So the influence of a particular criteria over itself is 0. So all the diagonal elements will be 0. Next, we ask the decision maker to find the value of other cell using this comparison scale. For example, the value of this cell represents the influence of storage space over price. If the storage space in the mobile is increased, the price also increases. So storage space have a high influence over price. So you can see that in the comparison scale, for high influence, a value of 3 is assigned. So this cell will assign a value of 3. Similarly, if you look at the influence of processor over the price of the mobile phone is very highly dependent on the type of processor used. So we can assign a value of 4 in this cell. Similarly, you can assign other values to get the direct relation matrix. In case of group decision making, if there are n decision maker, then we just take the average value. For example, in this cell, if there are 3 decision maker and the decision maker 1 gives the value 2 for this cell, the decision maker 2 gives a value of 3 and the third decision maker gives a value 4. Then the average of 2, 3 and 4 will be 3. So the net direct relationship matrix in this cell, the value will be 3. Similarly, you can compute it for all other cells. Next, we normalize the above direct relation matrix using this formula. The summation part, you can see the formula, the summation part of the formula is shown here. We just add all the values in the row to get these values. Next, we find the maximum value in the summation column. You can see that 7 is the maximum value in the summation column. So you can see the formula, we divide it with the maximum value. So we divide the values of the direct relation matrix with 7. On solving, we will get the normalized direct relation matrix, which is represented by X. Next, we calculate the total relation matrix using this formula, where I represent the identity matrix. I'll be using the MATLAB for finding the total relation matrix, that is T. This is the MATLAB interface. In the workspace, I'll be creating a variable and name it as X. Open the variable and paste all the values from the direct relation matrix. Close the variable and solve for getting the total relation matrix. This is the command for finding out the identity matrix, in which we also need to provide the size of the matrix. So here you can see that the size of X is 4 cross 4. So we have to give or provide a value for identity matrix or the size of the identity matrix, which will be 4 cross 4. Now this is the total relationship matrix. This is the total relation matrix T, which provide the information on how one factor or criteria affect another. Next we calculate D, which is the sum of the row, and R, which is the sum of column. Now on adding all these values, you will get this value. Similarly, you can get all other values by adding all the elements of the row. Now adding all the values in the first column, you will get this value, that is 5.046257. Similarly, you can get all other values by adding all the elements in the row. Now these are the D and R values of each criteria. Next we calculate D plus R and D minus R. Now D plus R reveals how much importance the criteria has. D plus R indicates the degree of relation between each criteria with other criteria. Now the criteria having more value or higher value of D plus R have more relationship with another criteria, and those having little value or smaller value of D plus R have less relationship with other criteria. Now you can see that cost have the highest D plus R value, which indicate that cost is the most important criteria among all other criteria because it has the maximum relationship with other criteria. D minus R tells us about the kind of relation between criteria. When D minus R value is positive, the criteria belong to the cause group, which is also known as dispatcher. So storage space, camera and processor have a positive value of D minus R. So these criteria fall under cause group, which indicate that these three criteria influence other criteria. If the D minus R is negative, the criteria belongs to the effect group known as receiver. Now price is a receiver or falls under the effect group, which indicates that price get influenced by other criteria. Now these are the D plus R and D minus R values. Next we will create the causal diagram using the scatter plot in Excel. Now this is the scatter plot in which D plus R is represented in horizontal axis and D minus R is represented in the vertical axis. The causal diagram, which is also a digraph, which explains the concept of direct and indirect effect of various criteria like price, storage space, camera and processor over each other. Now it's up to the decision maker whether he wants to set up this threshold value to identify all the criteria which have negligible effect over other criteria. Thank you and have a nice day. Please do subscribe my channel and also press the bell icon so that whenever I upload a new video, you may get notified. Thank you.